We are loaded up. Got Casey Gray with me. Up this flooded water. This is the road that you see right here. This is the end of the line. We fixing to go upstream. We going to look for a few deer. Y'all hang with them. See that high ground. He ain't lived.
Bitch. Boom.
another boat out there. That may be Dusty's boat right out yonder. We're gonna paddle out here and look around anyway. Knock a camera off over here. Ooh, what we on? I think your paddle must be broke. That really could be Dusty's boat. He lost it somewhere upstream. That makes number what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 bucks. 7 antlered deer that we have seen. Casey has missed 2 of them.
The biggest one and the smallest.
Yes, sir. Well, let's see if we can turn this 16-foot canoe around in this 14-foot wide span of water. Look like we're trying to turn an 18-wheeler around on them. All right, pull yours out. Well, I just made a shot. And shot a tree into at the same time. So I knew it went slam through him. Gonna see what he is. Let me get out of the boot. I don't know.
That's like a handle, man. That thing feels good.
I'm recording you.
Are you?
Let's go, yeah.
You can delete whatever you need to.
All right, now we got a difficulty. He's laying all on one side. We need to pull his butt over here or his head over there. Pull his head back down in over there. Probably be the best thing. You took him horns under that seat, maybe. That'll center him up a lot there.
That's what we want to do, right?
And you slide him back, yeah. The weight needs to come back to the center of the boat anyway.
You get a hold of
a leg. If I can get a hold of a tail over here, let me get a hold of this tail. He's crapping in my boot.
Now I'm going to have a horn in the back. Pull him a little bit more.
Hey, will one of them strings reach in time?
It just a little bit. The hair. All right, it won't be on me now.
Yeah, I just got to thinking that that weight all on one side ain't gonna be nearly tippy. All right, now we got him in here now. Let's rock and roll. See if we can get us another one.
We just gonna have to do this every year around the time of the rut. Around December the 18th.
This makes deer number what, about 10 that we've seen? He just was ignorant enough to stand there. No, he was in a good enough location, he didn't think we could get to him, is what he thought. I'm anxious to see how old he is. He's got 3 points. He's only got 3 points, but he is a huge, massive deer, and his teeth wore down, so we know he's old. We hung up on that log right there, Casey.
I'm trying to get situated.
All right, where are we going? It's a long way to make that loop, but it's virgin territory. Ain't nobody been in it today.
Good. How long do you think? I mean,
we're looking at a couple of hours. We're gonna be in the dark getting back.
What other choice we got?
Going back the way we come. I really don't know.
We'll be downstream either way, won't we? Eventually.
Where did we come from?
I don't know. Let's pull back up here. I want me one in Coke. A Coke or Mellow Yellow one. I got a pound in
there. There's water up there in front of you. There's a Coke. You want the Coke or the Mellow Yellow?
I don't care. I'll drink either one.
I don't care.
You sit right here and decide what we're going to do while we sip on this Coke. I mean, we pretty much made the day. I've been close to 200 pounds.
He's at least 200. We're going to wait. We're going to hang him up and wait when we get out there and see what he is. Get our nerves all back in check. All right, this is downstream.
We come from the other way.
This bends and goes back upstream, so all this is just dead water out here, right?
It's just a little current cutting through this, going out in it.
It's going to be a pretty good ways. Yeah, we in there just duck lake. It's a pretty good ways on up to
where I was talking about.
Right here. Look right there.
What?
Straight across that bank. He's got an island to go right back out in the yonder.
Yeah, I know it. He had the perfect location. That's why he sat right there. He didn't think we could get to him.
Somebody come for me from there. He goes.
Look at where we going. I was playing with a camera. He was up there fighting and I'm playing with a camera.
What?
Yeah. I'm just trying to get a little footage. They come right around that lake. They still running. That tree's been there quite a while. I paddled by and filmed the one over there at Shields Crossing that's right down below it the other day. It's not as pretty a tree as that. It's a little bigger around than that one, but that's an old tree right there. Bottom of it.
I think the whole thing
is hollow. Yeah, it's definitely hollow. There's a hole up in the side of it up there. We're fixing to get one of them spring loaded limbs. Did the first time, but we come back, went out there, and that's where we got in all the deer. Earlier when we come into this place, when we first got down here, we come to right here and rattled a little bit. We jumped a couple of deer up coming in on the bank. Two does and two bucks got up and run off. And we paddled on down here and we kind of got out. We're standing there looking, got back in the boat, paddling back, and we decided to rattle and grunt, stomp in the leaves. And we did that before we got in the boat coming back this way. And on the way back, we had a nice buck standing on the bank right out here. And we missed it. And we thought we'd come back late this evening and see if we could stir them up again. We know that there's at least four bucks in here. One of them literally run within 15 foot of me. He was real small, 4 or 6 point, I don't know. I didn't really count him, but he was real small. I didn't shoot at him. But they were two nicer bucks and one really good buck. So that's why we stopped right here, rattling and grunting. But we're pretty sure the deer had bedded back down because the one that we've got in the boat was bedded down when we shot him. And we've jumped two more up on the bank since then. You never get footage of them when you film and jumping up, but we've jumped a couple of does up on the bank. But when we were out walking around looking to see about the one that we shot at and realized we missed it, there's rubs and scrapes everywhere in this area. And no, we're not telling you where it's at. But it's on public land. I seen more deer and antlers in this spot at one time probably ever have in my life. Only one of them was really a really good buck. The other two were shootable bucks. We've seen a lot of deer today. How many deer we seen today, Casey?
I don't know.
At least 15, ain't it? Somewhere in the neighborhood of 15 to 20 deer that we've seen today. But it's because we're in this canoe and we can paddle into areas that nobody else can get to today unless they, and really can't even get a motorboat into these places. Because you can get over blowdowns, you can get over all this stuff. A lot of people are just not gonna drag a John boat over. You could get a John boat here with a motor, but you'd work yourself to death to do it. We've wedged in between tupelo gum trees and cypress trees to get, just make a little racket. I think what had everything stirred up is there was one hot doe in this area. She come through here this morning. And they was all chasing her. Her shot way off. There's some other folks having a little bit of luck. If anything changes, we'll get back with y'all. Nothing else. Y'all have a good one. Thank y'all for watching our video.